In September of 2010, 20 people from various parts of the world gathered in Manteles, a small village in central Ecuador, not far from the active volcano of Tungurahua. The purpose of the meeting was to find ways to expand the ideas of rights of nature around the world.
Queremos crear una alianza para poder trabajar juntos y promover los derechos de naturaleza, transversalizándolos en los diferentes temas que trabajamos.
Why was a global movement to protect the rights of nature being launched in the small country of Ecuador? Because 3 years earlier, in 2008, Ecuador had made history by becoming the first country in the world to give nature legal rights in their new constitution.
En armonía con la madre tierra, Pachamama, también para darles energía a ustedes.
We go now to the town of Monte Cristi, Ecuador, where the 2007-2008 Constitutional Convention took the historic step of giving nature a legal voice to defend itself for the first time in human history. This was a step that legal scholars consider to be on a par with ending slavery as a legal institution.
En el campo del reconocimiento de la naturaleza como sujeto de derechos es revolucionario.
Presiding over this constitutional convention was Alberto Acosta, president of Ecuador's National Assembly. Indigenous leaders came to the historic meeting too, representing tribes all over Ecuador. They came to urge the government to protect Mother Earth, what they call Pachamama. They also came to bring blessings to the National Assembly members to help them make good decisions on behalf of Pachamama as they were writing the new Monte Cristi Constitution of 2008.
Quienes apoyaban esta iniciativa no eran los juristas, los abogados jóvenes, sino las personas de más edad. Los jóvenes tenían una formación demasiado liberal. Para ellos era demasiado complicado aceptar que un animal sea sujeto de derechos.
2 years later, in early 2010, in Cochabamba, Bolivia, another historic step for nature's rights was taken.
Madre Tierra. Pachamama, Keipacha, Hanapacha, Ujupacha, Causaima, Ketexemuniunti, Wawamasiki.
Perhaps the world has never seen such a great and spontaneous gathering of so many diverse peoples from all over the world, including those from many indigenous cultures whose lives are still deeply rooted in the rhythms of nature.
Autoridades indígenas originarias de los cinco continentes.
Following the United Nations Climate Conference in Copenhagen, held at the end of 2009, where governments failed to reach agreement for halting runaway greenhouse gases, a growing number of people around the world woke up to the urgent need to self-organize on behalf of Mother Earth. Protecting nature and the future of humanity was too important to leave in the hands of government officials.
This poem is entitled, I Will Not Dance to Your Beat. I will not dance to your beat if you call plantations forest. I will not sing with you if you privatize my water. I will drag you to the climate tribunal if you pile up ecological debt and refuse to pay your climate debt. I will make you drink your own medicine if you endorse genetically modified crops. I will not dance to your beat unless we walk the sustainable path and accept real solutions and respect Mother Earth. Unless you do, I will not dance to your beat. Muchas gracias.
In Cochabamba, 30,000 people from over 100 countries came together for 1 week in April of 2010, calling for protecting the rights of Mother Earth and creating a document entitled the Universal Declaration of the Rights of Mother Earth.
Comprender el camino de la armonía con la naturaleza y el respeto a la vida. Requerimos forjar un nuevo sistema que restablezca la armonía con la naturaleza y entre los seres humanos. Solo puede haber equilibrio con la naturaleza si hay equidad entre los seres humanos.
I don't know that we're going to get a specific document that's going to work at the United Nations. What we're getting is this very, very strong alignment among people that this is a very important issue, and I think what will come out of this is the issue will be part of discussions in national conventions. It'll be part of discussions in municipal discussions. Civil society is going to be activated out of this and is going to get really involved and make sure that this discussion about rights for nature and how to activate it will come out of this. It's going to come out of this conference for sure. There's going to be a lot of people engaged in this conversation now.
I spoke today at the panel session about how when a caterpillar transforms into a butterfly, those cells have a plan of what to do. And changing these fundamental beliefs in our legal system is like changing the DNA in our legal system. It establishes a pattern which, will, when you act on that pattern, will create a new society. If you act on the rights of Mother Earth and you implement them, it affects everything, and it will slowly bring about the kind of transformation which you see when a caterpillar changes to a butterfly.
Cochabamba, Bolivia was the seed from which was born the Global Alliance for the Rights of Nature. As we saw at the beginning of this film, 6 months after Cochabamba, a small group of people from five continents came together in Manteles to launch the Global Alliance. The alliance was created to promote the creation of natural communities that respect and defend the rights of nature, as well as to help build the growing global social movement calling for a new way of living in the world and with nature. In January of 2014, the Global Alliance for the Rights of Nature convened a second conference in Pinsiqui, an indigenous town north of Quito. Presentations were made about man-made ecological disasters around the world. We also learned how local groups are fighting back, bringing the concept of rights of nature into municipal ordinances, challenging corporate power, and more. In Otavalo, working groups formed to collect and share ideas and experiences.
Los gobernantes, el sistema, hacía una ley. Sentado en la mesa, se sentaban el empresario, el ministro, el abogado, y hacía una ley que no iba solo en contra de los derechos del hombre. Hacían una ley que iba en contra de todo un sistema de vida. Porque todo ese conjunto que se llama Pachamama, Causa Xacha, Rona, es un sistema de vida. Y si eso se lo rompe, la vida cambió. La paz terminó. La libertad se fue. La Madre Tierra se estorbó.
Our Congress and the United and our state legislatures are very much in the business of writing laws to make sure that our communities get fracked, drilled, mined, that get their water privatized, and so on. What we learned as an organization was that if we were to make real fundamental change, that we had to begin at the grassroots in our communities. We have now worked with over 150 communities in the United States to put in place what we call community and nature's rights laws. So we have communities that have banned fracking. We have communities that have banned mining. We have communities that have banned the privatization of their water. But it's not just enough for them simply to ban something they do not want. They also have to put in place a structure of law at the local level to define what they do want. And that means establishing community rights to self-governance as well as the rights of nature.
We got to create something new. And as indigenous people, I said that here the other day. I said, when we're talking about rights of Mother Earth, I'm talking about how my relationship to Mother Earth gives me life. Gives me life. Maka wichoni maku, Mother Earth, okay? Maka kunshi wichoni maku. My grandmother Earth gives me life, okay? Very important concept of life. And not allow life to be co-opted by money, not allow life to be co-opted by capitalism. And that's what they're doing now. They're privatizing life itself.
Gandhi gave us three very powerful words. Swaraj, which means self-organization, as real freedom. And we now realize through biology that self-organization is the nature of life. But Gandhi taught us that self-organization is the nature of freedom. No one gives you freedom. You live your freedom. Second was Swadeshi, that we had been colonized by destroying our textile industry. And Gandhi pulled out the spinning wheel to not just be a force against the empire, but a force of self-empowerment. And making your own cloth became the idea of another economy, of the local, using your resources, your intelligence, your knowledge to provide for what you need. Swadeshi is the other economy, and Satyagraha, the fight for truth, the salt Satyagraha, where he told the British, we will not obey your salt laws because nature gives it for free. We need it for our survival. We will not obey your laws. And he went to the beach and picked up the salt from the sea. We've done the same with seed. We stopped a seed law in India that would have made it illegal for Indians to have their own seed.
After 3 days in Otavalo, Global Alliance representatives moved to Quito, where the Rights of Nature Ethics Tribunal was held, attended by a large public and the international press. This historic tribunal, presided over by Dr. Vandana Shiva of India, was created as a new venue for civil society to denounce serious environmental assaults taking place around the world today, both against nature and against those who seek to defend her. The nine cases presented to the panel of citizen judges included, among others, climate change, GMOs, fracking, open pit mining, and the extraction of oil in the pristine paradise of Yasuni, Ecuador.
Estamos hablando del proyecto Condor Mirador, un proyecto de mega minería, el primer caso en Ecuador de mega minería. La mega minería es una de las figuras extremas del extractivismo, una figura extrema que comparte con el fracking, con el agronegocio, con muchos de los temas que fueron tratados hoy. Estas características son las que hacen que en donde se haya, donde hay megaminería, se ataca directamente las funciones vitales de la naturaleza. Con esto adelanto mi voto, nuestro voto, de que este caso es considerado admisible en este tribunal.
Yo quisiera en esta ocasión, a nombre del atún azul, a nombre del tiburón tigre, a nombre de los delfines, al nombre del plancton y de los microorganismos del Golfo de México, permítame, a nombre del agua, a nombre de la tierra, a nombre de la atmósfera que por la fractura hidroeléctrica están siendo afectados en los Estados Unidos, permítame, a nombre de las selvas, a nombre de los bosques, a nombre de los ríos, de la zona de Chevron Texaco, permítame, a nombre de las mariposas, a nombre de las orquídeas, a nombre del ecosistema, a nombre de todas más los anfibios de las aves y también de los dos pueblos no contactados del Yasmín. Permítanme, a nombre de los peces y a nombre de todos los animales que viven en el arrecife coral, permítanme, a nombre de la vegetación, de la fauna, del agua, del cóndor mirador, permítanme, a nombre de las moléculas del ADN, de las abejas, de las gallinas, de las ratas, del maíz, de la soya que están siendo alterados por los transgénicos, y permítanme por el planeta que con el cambio climático se está afectando, y también permítanme por esos defensores de los derechos de la naturaleza, pedir a ustedes, miembros del tribunal, que acepten y declaren admisibles todos estos plazos para que, tarde o temprano, este tribunal, el único que conoce específicamente los derechos de la naturaleza y los defensores, pueda declarar los responsables. Podamos declarar las formas de restaurar y ojalá hacer un llamado ético para que esto pare, porque si no paramos, está perdido el planeta y estamos perdidos todos. Muchísimas gracias.
After listening to the cases presented, the tribunal's 9 judges determined that all of the cases were violations of the rights of nature. The president of the tribunal closed the session after ratifying the decision of the judges and again emphasized the importance of taking action on behalf of the rights of Mother Earth.
No hay tecnología alguna que nos garantice que no vaya a haber un derrame y se provoque una grave afectación a la naturaleza. Tenemos información suficiente. Este es un caso, compañeras y compañeros del tribunal, que cuenta con una amplísima información. Información proporcionada por quién? Por el propio gobierno que durante más de 6 años defendió la tesis de dejar el pudo en el subsuelo.
Tribunal Judge Alberto Acosta called for opening a special tribunal about the Yasuní ITT.
Nosotros deberíamos constituir una sala especial del tribunal para abordar el tema del Yasuní TT. El tiempo nos obliga a actuar ya y a ser eficientes con esta decisión. Tenemos también que, en este momento, desde el tribunal, alentar el trabajo de los defensores de la naturaleza, aquellos que están siendo criminalizados, y concretamente de quienes están recogiendo firmas en las calles y plazas para que se cumpla la Constitución y se defienda la vida.
What we are witnessing at this point of history is a further concentration and convergence of the power of the corporate state with militarized violence. Because that's the only way the system can carry on. And the criminalization of the defenders of the earth is an attempt to use force and violence against those who, with love and compassion and commitment, want to defend life on earth. So what does this tribunal offer us? It offers us a reversal of each of these wrong steps that have been taken. The first wrong step is the idea that human beings are separate from nature. And recognizing the rights of Mother Earth, in effect, becomes the best way to reclaim our humanity, to be full human beings as members of the Earth family. The second wrong step it enables us to take is to correct the ideas of a very convoluted, very artificial model of the economy based on an idea of growth that was cooked up for the war. GDP was created for running the wars. Gross domestic product was designed to release money from society to the war economy. And what was supposed to have just been used for a short time has become permanent instrument of war against the earth and war against people.
Lo que queremos es descolonizar nuestras mentes de un sistema que nos dice que somos individuos, que somos seres humanos separados de la naturaleza, de un sistema que nos dice que hay que crecer, que más es mejor, ¿no es cierto? Es un sistema que está completamente corrompido, es un sistema en crisis y tenemos que entonces volver a un enfoque ecosistémico, a un enfoque donde trabajemos como ecosistemas, en cooperación, en solidaridad, que nos demos cuenta que estamos completamente interconectados, que somos parte del todo.
This tribunal was called the seed tribunal. It's a seed sown which has a lot of potential. I support all the tribunal members who have recommended admission of all the cases for a deepening of the processes for justice and a deepening of the processes to stop the violation and violence against the earth. I know the creativity that we derive from the earth is a creativity that cannot be stopped. It cannot be threatened. It cannot be extinguished.